Some people have been interested in me reading poems and maybe saying a little bit about them. So I'm going to give my first poetry reading and see how it goes. I'm not going to explain a lot about it because it's pretty obvious, I suppose. It's Love 3 by George Herbert, and it was written a long, long time ago, around about Shakespeare's time. And so we're really looking at about 400 years ago. And I'm not going to explain the poem, but I want to speak to a couple of people whose lives it really was important to. One of whom is going to be the poet, obviously. I'll read the poem, I'll talk about the lives, and then I'll end off by reading the poem again, and you may hear different things in it. Love 3 by George Herbert. Love bade me welcome, yet my soul drew back, guilty of dust and sin. But quick-eyed love, observing me grow slack from my first entrance in, drew nearer to me, sweetly questioning if I lacked anything. A guest, I answered, worthy to be here. Love said, you shall be he. I, the unkind, ungrateful, ah, my dear, I cannot look at thee. Love took my hand and smiling did reply, who made the eyes but I? Truth, Lord, but I have marred them, let my shame go where it doth deserve. And know you not, says love, who bore the blame? My dear, then I will serve. You must sit down, says love, and taste my meat. So I did sit and eat. George Herbert wrote this poem amongst many that were like a private contemplation, little conversations with God. You can hear the conversation in that poem, and they were part of his personal meditations. And at the very end of his life, he wasn't a well man. He died at the age of 39, and he sent a collection of them to a friend, Nicholas Farrar, a little Gidding, with a note. If you think it may turn to the advantage of any dejected poor soul, let it be made public. If not, let him burn it. And his friend, of course, went, realised that they were special and published them a matter of weeks after his death. So the poet himself did not know or live to see his poems being published. But here they are in our ears a long time later. And his name is really well known as a poet. You will find no difficulty finding his poetry online and published commentaries. George Herbert. And his life is fascinating because he was born to quite an aristocratic family. His mother ran a salon, was the centre of literary life in London. He had brothers who were at court, and he had gone to Cambridge and studied, and he had a whole life ahead of him where he could have done any of the amazing things that his family were doing. They were very prestigious, very famous, very well known, and he chose to be a clergyman. And he chose to be a clergyman in a rural parish where the work was real and you were with people who were in difficulty and getting on with very basic things of life. And this poem mattered to somebody else who was also concerned with similar things. Simone Veil, spelled W-E-I-L, but she was a French writer, philosopher, but also very, very concerned with people who were living ordinary working lives and the dignity of the human life and how this was taken away by the way work was. And she went to the extent of working in factories herself and so forth. But she suffered a great deal from migraines, and she found this poem was one she turned to when she was feeling weak from having these migraines. And she would recite the poem, she would read it out, and as she did so, she felt that it was something helpful to her in the middle of the pain she was going through. And then eventually she began to realise that it was not so much reading the poem, but it was becoming a prayer. And then it became a spiritual experience for her that was life transforming. So I offer you this poem and a chance to hear it again. I'm just going to add a personal note. I did an exhibition of Stations of the Cross, contemporary art and poetry and music. And at the door to the exhibition, I had this poem printed out really large, A3, and framed. Because it's such an invitation, and I wanted it to be that sense that when you came to my exhibition, you were receiving this invitation of love. So I'll read it one last time. Love 3 by George Herbert. Love bade me welcome, yet my soul drew back, guilty of dust and sin. But quick-eyed love, observing me grow slack from my first entrance in, drew nearer to me, sweetly questioning if I lacked anything. I guess I answered, worthy to be here. Love said, you shall be he. I, the unkind, ungrateful, ah, my dear, I cannot look on thee. Love took my hand and smiling did reply, who made the eyes but I? Truth, Lord, but I have marred them. Let my shame go where it doth deserve. And know you not, says love, who bore the blame? My dear, then I will serve. You must sit down, says love, and taste my meat. So I did sit and eat. Bye for now.